to another collab challenge.
Ooh.
Except it's us.
That's right. I wrote 5, she wrote 5, and now you're gonna see our reactions to each point for the very first time.
Us learning new things. Ooh. Speaking of seeing something for the first time, from long lost communities to tribes discovering us for the first time,
today's list will cover all of this and more as we count down our list of top 10 uncontacted tribes we thought went extinct.
Let's do this.
At number 10, Pintupi Nine. In the 1950s, the British conducted the Blue Streak missile test over the Western Desert region. The Australian government decided to round up the desert nomads so that they wouldn't be hurt, which meant most of the Pintupi were taken away, except for one family known as the Pintupi Nine. They were entirely overlooked. That kinda sucks. They continued to live their traditional nomadic lifestyle, entirely unaware of European arrival at all. They had no idea about cars or even clothes. That's how far from the beaten path they traveled. It wasn't until 1984, when they finally met Europeans, that they discovered what they had missed. The Pintupi Nine stepped into the 20th century for the first time over 30 years ago, after living the nomadic lifestyle for 40,000 years. That's a lot of time. People close to the family say that the Pintupi Nine still talk more about family members who are still in the bush, but they have no idea what happened to them. Considering it took that long for the Pintupi Nine to be discovered, who knows how many other people are still out there.
Number 9, the Piripkura. When it comes to a lot of these uncontacted and indigenous tribes, we really don't know a lot about them, you know, because they're uncontacted. Well, bam. In the case of the Piripkura, we don't even know what they actually call themselves, if anything. Oh, that's weird, so we call them that? The outside world just named them the Piripkura, so I hope that's actually okay with them. By now they're like, that's the worst name ever! It means something obscene in their culture, that'd be so crazy. Last time anyone really checked in on them, around the late 90s, there were around 20 people left in their tribe. A lot was happening in the 90s. Furbies were the hot new sleep paralysis demons at Toys R Us. And the world saw 2 members of the Piripkura tribe emerge from the depths of the Brazilian forest. The pair came out seeking medical attention, and that's when they revealed the horrible things that this tribe had endured. The most heartbreaking thing that they shared was how much of their tribe had been massacred by non-indigenous people. Oh, that's awful. Causing their tribe's population to dwindle down significantly. At this point, because of the invaders in the forest and the illegal logging that happens around them, no one is even sure if there are any members of the tribe left. For all we know, they could be extinct, which I really hope isn't the case, because extinction is for dinosaurs. That's a good one.
I'm number 8, El Molo. The name El Molo means those who make their living from other than cattle. The population of the El Molo tribe in Kenya is getting smaller and smaller, with some thinking that they have all but vanished. But rest assured, they are still around, though their numbers are dwindling. Elusive and mysterious, the El Molo people are believed to have migrated from Ethiopia around 10,000 BC. Today they live in small villages on the southeastern shore of Lake Turkana. The reason their numbers are so low is because of their forced relocation and other tribe attacks. As other tribes expand their borders, they were forced to move farther south to the island of Goat. The tribe is also very vulnerable to disease due to their unbalanced protein-rich diet, which is another reason why they may soon disappear. However, it is their practice of inbreeding that may be their final act. The recessive genes cause them to age faster and expose them to disease. Their average life expectancy is 30 to 45 years of age, and with only 200 people left, researchers don't expect them to last long. But for now, they're still going, and who knows, they've survived this long after all.
Number 7, the Awa-Guaja. In just Brazil alone, there are an estimated 100 tribes who call the Amazon basin home. That's a lot of competition because, you know, survival of the fittest. Hey, not only that, but illegal logging has also caused a significant threat to their homes and a way of life because they keep being pushed back further away from their homes due to deforestation. The Awa-Guaja have been able to defy the threats of blatant capitalism and environmental ruin because they are known hunter-gatherers who live life in a similar way to the Neolithic humans back when woolly mammoths roamed the earth. The people in this tribe make their own weapons like bows and arrows and are known for the craftsmanship, having created things like hammocks out of nothing but palm fibers, hopes, and dreams. Great. The coolest thing about this tribe though is the fact that they keep monkeys as pets. Amazing. That is a dream we all wish we could fulfill. A couple of years ago, a member of the Awa-Guaja tribe was secretly recorded showing him hunting in the forest, but other than that, not much else has been seen from them.
At number 6, the Mascho Piro tribe. Peru's Amazon rainforest is a vast, mysterious landscape with secrets deeper and darker than anything in the Marianas Trench. The life of a man named Nicholas Flores was mysteriously taken and the death went unsolved. But prior to that, Flores had spent years trying to reach out to the Mascho Piro tribe. For over 100 years, people thought that they had disappeared were it not for extremely rare sightings. The tribe was in fact living in complete isolation and experts at camouflage. Flores served as a conduit between the tribe's people, trading with them all in attempt to lure them out. But then one day in 2011, the relationship went sour and he wound up dead with an arrow in his heart. However, as of 2016, it appears that the Mascho are getting curious as sightings have increased and they're slowly starting to emerge. The Department of Native Isolated People and People in Initial Contact decided to send a team to engage with them after the death of another individual. They usually don't like to interfere, but with the threat of violence, they had to step in. Today, the tribe has created new bonds with select conduits, but remain mostly to themselves.
Number 5, the Jarawa. The Jarawa tribe is one of the tribes of the Andaman Islands who are believed to have been settled there for over 55,000 years. That means that they were among the first humans to get there, and when they did, they thought, hey, this place is bussin', let's stay. And so they did. The Jarawa tribe has approximately 400 members and they live in social groups of about 40 to 50 people, so they're a pretty close-knit group, much like the Bumblebee family, that's cute. Though they are overall very self-sufficient in their own environment, the Jarawa tribe got curious as to what was going on outside of their home, and they were in for a rude awakening in the 90s. In 1998, people from the Jarawa tribe emerged from their forest for the first time without their bows and other weapons to explore nearby establishments and settlements. As a result, the outside government decided that they wanted to intervene and tried to put together a quote-unquote master plan, their words not mine, to integrate the Jarawa tribe into modern society, giving them an economy to sustain, and even detailing what clothes the people would wear. As you would imagine, that wasn't a good idea. These types of plans had failed many times in the past and it was doomed to happen again. So later in 2004, officials decided to scrap that idea and leave the Jarawa tribe to be clearly the better choice there.
At number 4, the Karafawyana. This next lost tribe is so small that it's no wonder why people didn't know that they existed. With only 50 people in their community, they remain entirely isolated to protect their community. As a result, very little information is known about them. They are located within the Amazon regions of Brazil. Again, the Amazon, not really all that surprising. But despite living in isolation, they are still affected by the outside world. Illegal logging practices and destruction of their land are all threatening their way of life. Their practicing religion is based on the animals and plants that surround them, and as they suffer, so does the tribe. Further specifics about their beliefs remain a mystery, however. We do know that they are a nomadic hunter-gatherer tribe, but their horticultural practices remain foggy. Considering everything that's happened this year, I'm not surprised that they want to stay away from modern society.
Number 3, Rook. The Rook people of Vietnam are known as the world's most mysterious tribe, and for good reason too. These people live in freaking tunnels, bro, what? This tribe was known until the late 1950s when, during the Vietnam War, a series of explosions brought them out of the forest. In 1959, Vietnam soldiers first made contact with the Rook tribe, and since then, people have tried to learn more about this tribe. It is said that members of the tribe are very agile, being able to climb and swing through trees like George of the Jungle? That's so cool. They are also known to have magic abilities, or so it is said. One researcher who observed the Rook tribe said that among their witchcraft rituals, their most famous and most often used spells are blow open, blow close, and air cut. What? 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 I'm becoming more and more convinced that these people are airbenders or something. Their air cut spell is apparently a defensive spell that makes it so that when they whisper the incantation, beasts like tigers, leopards, and even wild elephants won't attack them. Sounds pretty OP to me, seriously. Unfortunately, other than their spells, agility, and cave dwelling, not much else is known about the Rook tribe, so they remain just as much a mystery to us as we are to them.
At number 2, the Toromona. The Amazon, man, what the heck is up with that place? So many things that can kill you, and you can make mysterious friends. What a place to be. The Toromona are a group of people indigenous to Bolivia and live near the upper Medidi River. We know they exist, however, there has been little to no notable contact with this tribe beyond communication with other tribes. Because there are so little sightings, many doubt that they even exist, but they do. A Norwegian biologist went out searching for the tribe, but then mysteriously disappeared in 1997. His body never recovered, but they know he went missing near the Medidi Park. Most recent sightings occurred in the 21st century when the Arona people of Bolivia told Michael Broen that they made contact. Michael Broen is an anthropologist, and though nothing could be confirmed, he believes that the group finally came in contact with the Toromona. However, it looks like sightings become less and less as Bolivia's administrative resolution created an exclusive, reserved, untouchable portion of the Medidi National Park to protect the Toromona.
Number 1, the Sentinelese. The Sentinelese tribe are known as the most isolated tribe, and when I tell you they do not like outsiders, they do not like outsiders, and we're not talking about the movie. They don't like us in general, they just don't like anyone else. Get out of here. These people live on a small island called North Sentinel Island, and they do not welcome visitors looking for an island getaway. In fact, the moment an outsider steps foot on their land, it's basically game over, and not in the fun video game kind of way. The Sentinelese have been known to attack anyone who invades their home, which is the biggest reason as to why we don't know much about them. People have tried to make contact with the Sentinelese in the past. Most attempts were unsuccessful, with the tribe either being completely unwelcoming to the outsiders, or being open to contact, then suddenly turning hostile. But there have been somewhat successful attempts, as they've accepted gifts from authorities. So, acceptance by convenience. They're like, ooh, that looks good, we'll take that now. Go away. I mean, sure, they tricked them into giving them food and then shot arrows at them, but it was the most positive response they'd had so far. Officials have since decided to leave the tribe alone, since they weren't getting anywhere with them and didn't want to risk getting anyone sick, since because the Sentinelese are so isolated, they don't have immune systems the same as ours, and any of our germs could easily wipe out their population. Bottom line here is that they exist, but they want you to forget that they do. Sort of like the Men in Black and Aliens. Thank God you made the reference. So get your neuralizers out and forget I told you anything about them.
So that was our list of the top 10 uncontacted tribes that we thought went extinct. What'd you guys think? Good, bad, mediocre?
Also, did you guys learn something new? We hope you did, because we certainly learned a lot.
Definitely. Anyways, I've been one of your hosts for this one, Three Room.
And I'm Rachel Fisher, and until next time,
stay sweet, bumblebees!
Eee. Eee.